I just realized I don't know how to do this.
It's okay.
Can you introduce me?
I am. You need a second to pull up the questions.
You know what? Okay, that's fine.
Why don't you introduce yourself?
You got me there. Yo, my best friend
till the very end. Cause best friends don't have to pretend. You need a hand. Hi guys, so welcome back to my channel. this is Julia. She's like kind of my best friend, I guess, you know.
She's always trying to catch my hands.
And I dragged her into doing this video with me.
Yeah.
So we're just gonna dive right in.
Yes.
So the first question is, when and how did you meet?
That was, so I met her first day of freshman year. First day, I'd say, right?
Yeah, well, so the way our school did it was like welcome week. So yeah. The freshmen had the campus to themselves for a week, so we met. No, because you came in to introduce yourself to me and my roommate because, okay, we were suite mates. So like our two rooms shared a bathroom.
Yeah.
And you came in to introduce yourself, but I wasn't there because me and my dad went shopping.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah, I only introduced myself to Bunny.
I think you met me when another girl from our hall was drunk and crying in my room and you came in to see what was wrong.
That is exactly what happened because I was just minding my business peeing, you know? And I hear hysterical crying and I'm like, oh my god, what's happening? And I go over and there's this girl just on the floor, her tears everywhere. And I look at Lena and I'm like, is everything fine? Like, I'm Julia, by the way.
Yeah, you know, she's having a rough night. Like, this guy that she thought she didn't like, turns out she does like him and he's fucking some other girl, so.
As it goes.
Yeah. Number two, what was your first impression of one another?
I thought I was gonna hate her.
I actually thought I was gonna hate you too.
I didn't think that I was going to like you. Like, I thought we were just gonna be civil, mm-hmm. like, the whole time we lived together, and I was just never gonna see her again after freshman year. And then I was like, oh, so she's actually not a shitty person.
I mean, that's debatable.
Got me there.
But yeah, I thought it was too, because you and me and my roommate and your roommate had a group chat.
Yeah.
And like, your roommate like never talked, but my roommate was like the one that talked the most, and yeah. You guys would hit it off a lot. And I was like, I hope you know that you're not going to be closer to my roommate than I am, so back the fuck off.
And then things just unfolded the way they did.
Yeah, you know, and then we both ended up hating both of our roommates, so.
It was really fun.
It was really fun. Describe each other in one word.
Bitch.
Cunt.
Yeah, but like, add lovable dash.
Lovable.
In front of both of those.
No, actually, like, real talk, I would say loyal. You're actually very loyal.
Oh, we're getting serious.
We are getting serious.
Oh, God.
You are, because, like, okay, yesterday you, like, rode in a car to a party with my ex-boyfriend, and, like, you gave him attitude, and, like, I really appreciate that.
I did. Yeah, I feel like I'd say the same for you, honestly, not to be, like, generic, like, oh, my God.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, you never like give me any reason to be like, fuck this bitch, like she's trying to kill me. Like,
okay, what's your favorite memory together?
Ooh.
Mine's like really sappy.
What is it?
Okay, so like a little over a year ago, I was broken up with and it sucked, and like we like the whole week, like, cause we've been fighting before that. Like, you've been trying to make me feel better, but I was like, oh, she's probably just doing this because she thinks she has to, or because it's, like, the right thing to do. But then, like, that Friday, like, after you broke up with me, he broke up with me on a Sunday, you, like, sat down, had lunch with him, and talked to him because, like, he wouldn't talk to me. And then when you came back to the room, you had to be the one to break the news to me that, like, he was, like, done with me. Like, it wasn't, like, a phase or, like, a break. Because he dumped me out of nowhere. That was really fun.
That was something.
That was great. He dumped me the night we came back from spring break, and she just came in the room and I was sobbing. And
we were in the middle of a fight.
We were. And she was like, okay, so what happened?
Yeah. I dropped everything and I was like, spill immediately.
But like, I hadn't, like, I'd been just like crying in my bed all week, and you came back to the room and like, you had a date later and you could have spent that time getting ready for your date, but you like, we ordered food, and you, like, showed me your favorite stand-up special on Netflix, and you know I love stand-up comedy, and I was like, wow, she's, like, a real one. Like, that was the first time I laughed, like, since he dumped me, and I was like, wow, she's, like, legit.
I feel like we've had a lot of good moments, but I feel like one of my favorites was, I would say, like, one of the first times we, like, really had a fight, and We were living together at this point because I moved in with her second semester freshman year, and then we like screamed at each other, but then we like made up and then just got Taco Bell like 10 minutes later and then decided to just watch The Bachelorette. And I thought that was really fun because like usually like people can't just snap back like that, but like we can, so I'm like, oh, okay, I'm like, this works.
What's something that annoys you about each other?
Oh god, the list goes on. I don't know, honestly. I feel like the fact that we talk mostly over text because she's not here anymore.
Yeah.
Thanks. And I feel like a lot gets like lost in translation there. Mm-hmm. So I feel like for both of us, like one thing that annoys me too is that we both jump to conclusions with stuff like that.
We do a lot.
Sure.
Because like if we're, and because like we text for most of like our conversations, if we start fighting over text because you can't tell like your tone of voice or anything, like if I like word one thing the wrong way, she's like, what the fuck did you mean by that? And like I'll do the same thing, and it's,
she's not wrong.
It's,
I'm
not
aggressive
wrong.
For no reason.
It's okay, shit happens. Okay, have you traveled anywhere together?
No. Not yet, no.
We're trying to go to LA together over summer, but we're both broke.
Yeah, that's, remind me.
But I think like we're both trying to meet each other's families finally, because like you, like we've met them over FaceTime, and I met your mom when she came to get you at the end of freshman year.
Yeah.
But we haven't like seen each other's houses, and like we need to meet each other's cats, because,
oh my god,
that's a thing we talk about a lot. If you could go anywhere in the world together, where would it be and why?
I really do feel like LA would be fun, dude. Like, I know we're trying to do that anyway, but I really think that would be, or New York together.
New York would be fun.
Because then I could show you everything.
Yeah, and like, I don't know, I've thought about this. I feel like we'd actually have a lot of fun on a cruise together, because we both love to nap, and that's somewhere where you, like, your room is right there, but then also, like, the whole vacation's right there.
Yeah, it is, so you're not missing anything.
Yeah, and we could, like, go clubbing every night and, like, pretend like we're gonna get dick, but we're not actually, because nobody wants us.
I love that. No, yeah, I feel like a cruise would be really fun, but, like, the funds? That's another story.
Oh, yeah, that's, like, a couple thousand dollars that we just don't have.
It's fine, we'll go, like, when we're, like, inevitably single moms.
You're right. Who takes longer to get ready in the morning?
I don't know. It depends on the day and what we're doing.
Yeah, because we think we're both fine, like, throwing our hair up in a bun and putting on a hoodie and leggings, but, like, when we want to look nice, like, we both take, like, a solid hour.
Yeah, I would definitely say, maybe I take a little bit longer because I have more hair.
Yeah.
That's about it, but other than that, like on the days that we both had class, like, we would just both get up and then be ready in, like, 10 minutes and it'd be fine.
And when we both got ready for the captain's ball together, which is like college prom.
Yeah.
Like that was, I think we both took 5 hours.
We did. That was, because we got ready with Nicole as well. Mm-hmm. And we all took like
a long time.
The whole afternoon into the evening.
Yeah. Favorite inside joke?
Oh my god, there's so many.
A lot of them come from stand-up specials we've watched.
I can't do it! That one's from Sebastian Maniscalco. You need to watch that immediately.
Love it.
Piss my pants every time.
Oh my god. What the f*** is this?
We also, my ex used to say milk instead of milk, and I really like that one.
There's also she gone.
She gone. Yeah, we were in the dining hall, and we were all getting dinner, and we all like went our separate ways to get our food. And then Julia came up to him. This was like, we weren't even dating him. This was like the first time that you guys like officially met.
Yeah.
And three of us went to get dinner. And you went up to me, you're like, hey, where'd Lena go? And he went, she gone. And I was like right behind
him.
Yeah. I was like,
you were like, hello, I'm, sir, use your eyeballs.
You have a special level of ADD though. Who's the better cook?
Considering I tried to put a whole box of frozen pizza bagels.
Oh my god, our food is here, I think. Hello? We're in the west entrance, which is like the back entrance. Okay, we had to get just like a light snack.
Okay, I'm not even in the frame.
Okay.
Perfect, because the last question that we left off on had to do with food, I think.
Yeah, who's a better cook?
Okay, so considering I tried to put a whole box of frozen pizza bagel bites into the microwave in the box.
Like 2 weeks ago almost burnt down your house while making grilled cheese.
I did do that. But sorry, like, mom.
Oh, this is for you. What's it like being friends with someone who's so obsessed with YouTube?
Honestly, I am equally as obsessed with it, I think. I just like don't have a channel of my own. Mm-hmm. So like
I'm it's okay, I'm funnier than you. Like don't worry.
No, yeah. We're like equally like obsessed with YouTube, I feel like. I'm always going back to YouTube when I'm bored.
Have you lived together?
Yes.
We lived together second semester of freshman year. We decided not to live together sophomore year for the sake of our friendship.
Yeah, because we probably would have murdered each other, honestly. Yeah. I feel like we would live better together if we had separate quarters.
No, I mean, I always tell people this. I think if, like, if in the future we ever, like, lived, like, in an apartment together where we had our own bedroom and bathroom and we just shared, like, a kitchen and living room, we would be totally fine.
Yeah, 100%. Because the problem was we couldn't get away from each other.
Yeah, that and, like, I had a boyfriend, and then as soon as my boyfriend broke up with me, you had, like, a
thing. Yeah.
And like we used to get really territorial, the other person being in the room when our guy was there. So
this is just bad all around.
Who's messier?
Neither of us are messy. Yeah. I would describe you as cluttery.
I am cluttery.
That's it. But I'm like OCD neat. Mm-hmm. So
I think I just, when I get like stressed, like, you know, being like neat or organized doesn't become a priority anymore. Mm-hmm. So I'll leave clothes around, or like there were always dishes in the sink, but like
that was always my fault too.
Oh, that was another inside joke we had, because RA, like the first week of freshman year, was like, communicate with each other, don't be passive aggressive. So like if someone was supposed to do the dishes and then they didn't, don't leave a sticky note on the mirror that says thanks for doing the dishes with a smiley face. And so then one time Julia forgot to do the dishes and I did that, and then I started leaving those sticky notes everywhere, like in like your bag of chips, like
in my book, under my pillow,
under your pillow. I taped one like inside of like, what is, I taped one to your water pitcher.
You did. And then there was one in my shoe.
Yeah, they were just everywhere.
And then you started throwing them at me.
Yeah, that's
like just pelting me with them from the top of your bunk. And I was like,
that's a video I have.
So funny. Insert.
I'll insert it here. Outgoing,
definitely you.
You think so? Really?
I would say so. I feel okay. Wait.
I feel like we're kind of the same.
We both despise social interaction. Like we're good with each other. We're good like with people we're comfortable around. But generally speaking, I would say that you're more friendly than I am.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I would say
unless somebody crosses me, then it's like
then.
I will rip you a new asshole.
Wow, promise? Who's nicer?
Who's nicer?
Her, hands down. I am the fucking bitch.
It's okay.
And you know it. Everyone knows it. I'm embracing it.
I feel like I'm one of the only people that like knows how to handle you. And even then, when I set you off, I get a little scared. I mean, my ex-boyfriend, who's like literally twice your size, like 200 pounds, 6'1", is terrified of you.
I find that funny.
What's the last movie you saw together?
What?
We don't really watch movies, we watch stand-ups.
Yeah, or Bachelor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the last thing we watched together was
Sebastian's Part 2. Yeah. That was so good.
There were a lot of
Jim, what are you doing in your bathroom with a bottle of Crest?
You take care of the tar, I'll go to bath time. Tell us something you got in a fight about.
What haven't we gotten in a fight about?
You're right.
Oh, here's one fun thing. I fucked up, I will admit. I accidentally gave your wine to people.
Oh, that was like our first fight.
Yeah, it was like two cupfuls of like a whole bag of sangria, and like I was already drunk, so I like, I mean, didn't think to ask.
I definitely overreacted.
But I also should have asked.
But yeah.
So that was our first fight.
Well, it was like, it was a little fight when it happened, because I just came up to the room and I was like, dude, that wasn't cool. And you were like, I'm sorry, you hate me. I was like,
yeah, because I was drunk and I was immediately like, oh my God.
And then the next day you were like, you know, I feel like you should have apologized too. And then it got bigger.
Yeah, it did.
And that was the fight where we were like, let's just go have Taco Bell after.
Yeah.
So.
And then we were fine.
We were fine. Who's the designated driver? Julia.
Yeah, God, never get in a car. Driver. Never get in a car with her. Oh,
there are worse drivers than me.
I don't know about that one.
The thing is, I learned to drive from my dad, and he's very jerky.
But, like,
yeah, I think, yeah, you're definitely a better driver. I mean, I was driving you home from a party yesterday, and I got on the curb at one point.
And you also didn't yield. Okay. That was really fun, and... Yeah, because I would say that you're like a careful, like a little too careful when you drive, and I'm just like straight up aggressive, like we'll hop the curb purposely to cut you off.
It's true.
It's fine.
It's because you're from Long Island.
Everything's fine. Just don't cross me.
This is a weird question, but who smells better?
I mean, all I know is that I bathe in perfume every day, basically. I don't literally
bathe. Oh, it's another inside joke. Okay, so one time I was laying in, like, the bottom bunk of our room last year with my ex, well, my now ex, and you were, like, Julia, like, sprays perfume, like, on her chest, and then, like, on her hips, and then, like, on her legs and her arms, and then she sprays some and walks through it, the neck,
yeah.
And he's, like, watching her do this process, and I wasn't thinking anything of it, because I witness it every day, and this is the first time he saw it, and as she's doing it, he goes, why don't you just drink it?
And I was like, what the fuck? Excuse me? I was just so, like, taken aback by that, because I was like, I can't even insult him back, because he's not wrong.
I lost my shit. Finally, read the most recent text exchange between the two of you. This could get inappropriate. Oh, it was just because I was going downstairs to let Julia in the building, and I was halfway through curling my hair, and Julia was like, I hate the wind. It messed up my hair at least 6 times before I got here. And I said, don't worry. When you see my hair, you'll feel better. And she said, can't wait. And I said, it's only half curled. This is great. And it was only half curled.
And then when I saw her, I went, you should just film like that. It's beautiful.
Is there anything else you'd like to say to my fans? Oh, God. All 64 of them.
I don't have a channel. I really am not that interesting, but thanks for having me.
I'll put your Twitter and Instagram in the description below.
I appreciate that. My mom's gonna be like, ooh, I can finally creep on her.
Don't forget to like and share and comment and subscribe and all that good stuff, and I'll see you guys next time.
Peace. Oh my God, do the James Charles outro. Be like, if you like to follow me on Makeup Journey, you can follow me at Instagram and Twitter at James Charles, and then for my Snapchat for more behind the scenes type stuff, this is James Charles with an extra S after Charles.
You watch too much James Charles.
James, if you see this, I fucking love you and I would die for you.
Okay. Bye.